I want to thank you all for coming. This is a fantastic crowd. Mr. President, it's nice to see you here as well. Well, this is really important stuff. Higher education is at an absolute critical juncture in our state's history, in our state's budget writing history. And I don't stand up and say I'm someone who cares about higher education because I'm the son of a university professor, or because I myself benefited from a fantastic public state education at Washington State University, but because higher education is the gem of what's right about Washington State and what's right about our America. It is essential for our economy. It is essential as a system of economic justice, social mobility, and equality. And it's a system that we continue to defund at our great economic and social peril. And as you go around this body, you will not find anyone who will not say that they care about higher education. You'll not find anyone that says they don't care about higher education. But unfortunately, there's been very, very few who have been willing to prioritize higher education. And this is really now a question of prioritization. Over the last 10 years, this state has spent a lot of money. And even at times of budget growth, higher education has been deprioritized. And in last year's budget, higher education was the absolute biggest loser. Because there's other forces at work here in the legislature that frankly have bigger constituencies and will always get more funding. So I went back and I've thought about this a lot over the last season, over the off season, and looked and analyzed how the budget negotiations have gone in the recent decade. And I've seen what's happening now in the ongoing budget negotiations. And I'm afraid to tell you, higher ed is set to be kicked in the teeth once again. We're almost on the verge of having the state completely out of higher education in the system that we knew it and that I benefited from. So in my mind, there's only one solution to this, and I'm going to ask you today to go out and fight for this solution, which is that higher education needs constitutional protection, and higher education needs a dedicated revenue source. And by my analysis, that's the only solution. And if other legislatures you talk to say they have a better solution, let them bring it forward. But please ask them to do more than just pay lip service to caring about higher education. Let's put it in the Constitution, and let's give it a dedicated revenue source. And I just want to say something about the cost of higher education. In my view, you know, one of the things the legislature did last year under this budget cuts is we said, well, let's not let the legislature set tuition, let's give it to the universities. And I thought that was a very poor decision, because what it allows is this body to wash its hands of that rising tuition instead of taking accountability for it. And I think that's a very, very dangerous thing for the state to do. But more importantly, what should higher education cost? Folks look at increasing costs and try to benchmark us against other states. Well, I don't care if other states are defunding their higher education. I care about higher education here in the state of Washington. And what I think higher education should cost is what about the amount that a student could work a summer job and maybe a little part-time work and be able to pay for college or university without going into debt. When I went through WSU, the tuition was about $3,000, which allowed me to get through school without immense amount of debt. And what the state has done is shifted the cost to students and to working families and to middle-income kids, and many of you are having to build up a tremendous amount of debt. This is going to imperil your choices in the future, imperil our economy, and essentially imperil the America that we know it. So my Senate resolution is 8225. It would restore enough funding to revert to a 50-50 split between the state and the student. But more importantly, it would get it in the Constitution as the second priority of the state. Right now, the state of Washington says that K-12 is the priority. I'm fine with that. But I think higher ed needs to be number two, because if we don't prioritize in the Constitution, the legislators writing budgets in this body will not prioritize it. So I hope you take that to heart. I hope you got one of these handouts, you think about it, and I hope you advocate for continuing not just care about higher education, but prioritization of higher education. Thank you very much. I'm State Senator Michael Baumgartner.